Luke? Luke, I'm sure it can't be as bad as you think.
Laura, don't, please.
Your life isn't over.
Don't you hear me? I said I was going to be dead, killed, little lady. What's the matter? Can't you get that through your head? Now get out of here.
Luke, I don't know what you're talking about, but we are your friends.
Please, don't. Don't.
And whatever problems you have, they can be worked out. Now, if somebody is after you or something, we can get the police.
The police? Leave it to you to think of that.
Luke, please don't drink. It's not going to solve anything.
I need this drink.
Okay. But look, let us help you. Anything can be worked out. Really.
You're incredible. Do you know that? I really think you should go home now.
No. I'm your friend, and I won't leave you here like this.
That's always been the trouble, you know? You never could. And you didn't know. You've never known where I was coming from, have you?
I know. I know that you care about me.
Damn it, Laura. I'm in love with you.
No, I don't think it's really love, Luke.
Yes. Yes, that's what it is. And it's like some kind of sickness inside me. It's eating me up. I can't concentrate on anything. And in my business, that's dangerous, baby. You got me between two worlds that don't mix.
I don't know what you're talking about, but I think I better...
That's right. You can't understand it. Why can't you understand me, Laura? I know why. Because you have Scotty. Do you know what it does to me? To know that you're in his bed every night. Do you know that all I care about is holding you? I need you. All I do is dream about you. I dream about holding you in my arms and making love to you. Laura, you are my life.
I'm sorry. I didn't know. Luke, I think I should quit my job here.
No.
Luke. Luke, my life with Scotty is all that I want right now, okay? Now, I know that you feel like your life is falling apart right now, and I'm sorry. But we can help you. Scotty and I are your friends.
Don't say that ever again, okay? Look, I don't want to be your friend, Laura. I don't want to be your friend, and I can't have you. You don't belong in my world. I don't belong in yours. Look what you've done to me. I'm not gonna die without holding you in my arms just one time. Dance with me, Laura.
No.
I said, dance with me.
Go now. Luke, let me call a taxi, please. You're frightening. No. No. Oh, Luke, let me go. No. No! No, Luke!
What are you still doing here?
You walked out, Tracy. I didn't. You interested in that game?
No, I'm not. I'm through with games.
It's a very wise move.
All right, Daddy, I have a move for you. I'd like you to leave.
Not yet. I haven't accomplished what I came here for.
Yes. You haven't signed the will.
I told you I wanted to do that in your presence, and I can now. But before I do that, Tracy, I want you to know exactly why I'm doing this to you. It's because you've allowed money to become a god in your life. You'd do anything to get your hands on that trust fund. I know that now. Ruin the family, destroy your brother, disgrace the family name, and most important of all, go against my direct orders, which only goes to prove that you no longer love me, if indeed you ever did.
It's not true, Daddy, and you know it.
When I signed this will, Tracy, I want you to know that I despise the very sight of you.
Daddy, don't hurt me this way, please.
I'm no longer your father, Tracy.
Daddy, don't you understand? You're the only one that ever really mattered.
Prove it. By dropping the paternity
test. Don't ask me, Daddy. I can't. I can't because I have gone too far.
I guess you have, Tracy. You've gone so far that you're no longer the daughter that I thought I once knew and loved.
No. You still love me. You have to.
I feel nothing for you, Tracy. Nothing at all.
Daddy, if you feel nothing for me, and you don't love me anymore.
I feel nothing but a deep sense of rage which is beginning to destroy me. You're going to regret this day, Tracy. You're going to know what I mean when I say I am cutting you out of the family, that you are no longer a quartermain. It means I never want to look on your face again. I don't want your family gatherings. I don't want you around me for holidays. And most of all, I don't want to even have to pretend that I still have a daughter.
Daddy, what's the matter? What is it?
My medication, Tracy. Give me my medication.
Daddy, you're having a heart attack.
The apartment. Big saw. Drawer. Top drawer. My pillow. Mary.
Daddy, I don't have a key to your apartment. You know, I always said I should have a key, but I don't.
It's here. Right here. I can't reach it. Tracy.
Okay, Daddy. Okay. Right here. In here.
Yes.
I can't.
Hurry. Hurry.
Here it is, Daddy.
Tracy.
You know, Daddy, it was really very careless of you to leave your apartment without taking your medication with you.
Tracy, I need my medication now.
That would help, wouldn't it?
Tracy.
Then you could live long enough to sign the will. Hi, Daddy. Cutting me off from the entire quartermain's fortune. Well, now, gee. That's something I'm going to have to think about, isn't it?
Tracy. Tracy, you don't know what you're doing.
You need me now, don't you, Daddy?
I've always needed you, Tracy.
How come you turned against me? As soon as that baby was born to Monica?
Please, Tracy.
You're begging me, Daddy. After you tried so hard to make me look like a liar and a fool.
We'll discuss it later, Tracy.
No, Daddy, there's nothing to discuss. Because I want you to know right now, no matter what happens, I'm not dropping that paternity test. And I am doing it for all of us, every last quartermain. For Mother, for Alan. But most of all, I am doing it for my own son, Ned. For my flesh and blood.
Tracy. Tracy, I can't breathe. If you ever love me, for God's sake, help me.
I don't have to prove I love you, Daddy. You know perfectly well. All quartermains love each other automatically. There's only one thing we love more. Isn't that right, Daddy? What is it, Daddy? Say it. What is it? It's money, Daddy.
Dear God,
And I learned that at your knee. You always said to me, Tracy, never count on people. Only count on money.
Tracy, on that case, please.
Daddy, if I get your medication, will you tear up the new will?
How can you talk about money? How can you talk about anything but my life?
I'm sorry, Daddy.
Tracy, get my medication, please.
Okay, Daddy, okay, all right, I'll get it.
Hurry. Oh, Tracy, please hurry.
But you know they weren't where you said they were. They weren't in the store at all. They were in the medicine cabinet. I had to look for them.
Just let me have them.
Daddy, will you tear up this will? If I can't enter, you will tear up the will.
If I won't.
Daddy, come on. Here it is. It's right here. Just tear it up.
I won't.
Daddy, I'll do it.
No. Oh, God's sake, help me, Tracy.
All you have to do, Daddy, is promise me you're not going to sign that will. That's all. Just one little promise.
I can't reach.
That's too bad, Daddy. I did what you told me to. I went next door and I got your medication for you.
Oh, Tracy. I died. I don't want to die, please.
You better take your pills, Daddy.
God damn it. If you love me.
Those are some terrible things to me, Daddy. You said some terrible, ugly things to me. You're a liar. I even have to buy them any marriage. Some of them don't like me. Some of them even love me. You bet some of them love me, Daddy. Want to know what the saddest part is, Daddy? The only man I ever loved was you! Thank you.
Feeling remarkably fine. Zelda, I want you to come over to Tracy's apartment and, along with Howard, I'd appreciate it if you call and get in contact with him. Oh, yes. Well, I want to apologize for calling so late, but I was sure you would understand. Oh, and Zelda, would you please bring the notary seal? Thank you.
Daddy!
Don't call me that, Tracy. I'm no longer your father.
Daddy, let's never do that to each other again, okay? Daddy, let's not play any tricks like that on each other ever again.
Is that what we were doing, Tracy?
Or did you bet? You were trying to get me to think you were really having a heart attack, and I was trying to get you to think that I was going to let you die.
You were very convincing.
You know, you weren't, not for a minute. I knew you were faking now. I want you to call Zelda back and tell her not to come, okay, Daddy?
Don't call me that. I am not your father. Tonight, I'm going to sign a new will.
No, you won't, Daddy.
Watch me. I'm signing it here. Tonight, you'll be disinherited.
You can't do me, Daddy. Do that to me, Daddy. You love me. You'll break my heart if you do.
You haven't got a heart, Tracy.
Daddy, you know how much I love you. And now you're just being cruel to me.
When I was lying on the floor there and you came over to me, were those genuine tears?
You know they were, Daddy. They were tears of love. You can't do this to your little girl.
Why did you leave me lying on the floor and go to the telephone? If you knew I was faking, why would I need an ambulance?
Daddy, come on! No more tricks! I love you!
Don't touch me! You know, Tracy, your touch sickens me. That's better. No more tricks from you either. All right, Tracy, I want you to go upstairs to your room and stay there until I call for you. And Tracy, I suggest you do a little praying now that I've disowned you. Pray that Mitch didn't marry you for your money. Pray that Mitch really does love you and will allow you to remain Mrs. Mitch Williams.